Okay, folks, the Luna BBSHD motor kit has arrived, and I have unboxed it. I'll run you through all the parts that are in the kit. First, let me say what a nice job they did packing things. This box here had all the motor and the small parts. This box here was the big battery and the charger by itself. So they shipped two boxes for this. And what I got here is a Luna Wolf version 2 52 volt pack, 13.5 amp hours with Panasonic GA batteries, and it's 702 watt hours. And let me say, this thing is made really well. It's all potted. It's got a metal plate here, and the connectors are, flip this around, holy mackerel, that thing's heavy. Connections are on this end. Right now I'm charging it. Came with this charger here. Run you down the parts here. Some connectors to and from the motor and battery. They're using these monster rare earth magnets on your water bottle cages bolt holes there, and it sticks to this metal plate. And I tell you, I picked one up and got it close to the metal plate and it sucked it out of my hand, and I had a hard time getting that magnet off this metal plate. So I'm kind of thinking you also need maybe some sort of a Velcro wrap around, maybe, for, we'll see how good the magnets hold. There's two of them, so we'll see how that goes. And then moving on, this is the gear shift sensor. It senses when you're shifting and cuts the motor. And these are the two hydraulic brake lever sensors. And you get little magnets with those that have to go on the levers. And when the magnet gets close to this thing here, it senses that you've pulled the brake lever and it cuts the motor also. And this is the wheel sensor and a magnet that senses the speed. You put it on the spokes and it goes by here, sends speed info to the controller. And this is a left-handed thumb throttle. And this is the 750C color display with thumb control unit. And I bought the Luna wrench for the bottom bracket tightening of the motor because I don't have anything to fit that. I don't have a spanner to fit that. And I probably have something for that, which is this ring here. But it's a nice tool. Looks all stainless. So I got that, with added that to my kit. Then go down here, I bought a spacer kit because it's a 120 millimeter motor, and I've got a 112 millimeter bottom bracket. So I've got to make up 8 millimeters here. So that's what all these spacers are here. And some bolts came with the spacers there. Not sure why those bolts are there, but these black bolts are the bolts that I checked and you use to go through this ring to the motor to secure it. There's other videos on YouTube where you can see people actually doing detailed installs. I'll go through my install, and I'm not going to do step by step. I'll just do stages. Then we go over here, the crank arms, the crank bolts, and the stock chain ring. They sent a 46 with this one. I don't think I'll ever use it on this bike, but for a road bike or something, that might be pretty good. But I bought this little 30 tooth ring And then I have to see what my chain line offset is going to be when I'm done. I'm going to have to make some adjustments on the freewheel in the back there. And then this is the connector that connects to the motor and then branches off and goes to the brake sensors and speedo and the display. And then finally, here's the monster. Here's the Bifang BBSHD from Luna with 120 millimeter bottom bracket spacing. I just put it on the scale. It weighs a little over 13 pounds. It's a handful. But what I'm going to do now is just start assembling. And I'll check back in a bit and add some more to this video as I go. Oh, by the way, let me swing over here to the bike here. I took the wheels off and took the crank off, getting ready for the install. So I'm just down to a frame right now. But anyways, the build is about to begin. It's going to be a rainy weekend. This is Friday night, so it's going to be a fun weekend, even though it's raining. Okay, later. Well, kids, the beast is up and running. Last night, I mounted all the Luna BBSHD kit stuff. Took it out for a quick test ride, but it was about 10 o'clock at night, so I only went like a mile, came back. But today I straightened up all the wiring and just checked everything over, make sure I tighten everything. But I'm going to give you the walk around here now. So this is the 750C color display. And it fits nicely over the fat bars here. Sits right on top of the stem. It's got some nice nice display features here. See if I can get over here out of the light. I have to go off the side over here. I'm going to hit the throttle here. I've set it to miles per hour and some of the stuff in the menu. By the way, you hit the M button twice. Do it real fast. And then it goes in the setup menu. And there's two tabs at the top. And this is display settings. And then you hit the power button and it goes to basic settings. And then let's see, I think you hold the M button to get out of this. You got to go on the bottom. I'm looking through the camera screen. I can't see what I'm doing here. All right, exit. There we go. All right, we're back to the display here. Okay, on the handlebars here, I've got the assist controller here. Here's plus and minus. It's got five levels of assist. Let me go over here and see if, hope this focus is good. There's zero, no assist. Plus button, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you can set that in the menu, how many levels of assist you want. I'm gonna put on zero now so I don't accidentally hit the motor. And then I mounted a thumb throttle here. I have the two brake sensors, but I haven't hooked them up yet because it requires putting a magnet in a sensor, and then when you pull the lever, the magnet moves away from the sensor and shuts the motor off. And these brakes, I don't know how I'm going to do that yet, but the bike will run without the brake sensors on. So here's the big Luna Wolf battery, 52 volt, 13.5 amp hour, 702 watt hours. And it's held on the frame by a couple monster magnets on the water bottle cage. And what I'm going to do is, and they give you a couple booster straps here just to secure it. But I tell you what, the magnets are so strong, I have a hard time pulling this off the frame. I'm going to put another riv nut in the frame up here, because two of the magnets are way down here where the water bottle cage is. So I'll leave one there and move one way up here, so I get a magnet mounting surface there and here, which will be a little bit better than the way it is now, two right there. But anyways, I don't have the proper riv nuts here. I've ordered those for my shop. I use them in my shop anyways. So here's the big BBSHD with the hot rod package from Luna. And I've taken the stock wires coming from the motor and put this second plug on here that they send with you, because normally it's going into an Anderson power pole connector from the motor, and then a little pigtail adapter they give you that has an Anderson on this end and this connector on the other end. So I just went direct and eliminated the pigtail connector. Little note on this. This has a 112 millimeter bottom bracket, and they give you these big metal spacers right here, but they were 20 millimeter, so I had to take them down 8 millimeters. So I sawed it off with a hacksaw real close to 8 millimeter, and then put it on my lathe and trued up both surfaces down to 8 millimeter, which took up this space perfectly. If this was a 120 millimeter bracket, this ring would have been way out here and I wouldn't have had to do that, but it's no big deal. I got the tools in the shop to do that. And I tell you, I spent a lot of time routing the wires real pretty here, because there's a pigtail harness comes off the motor, goes into this big connector, and I've routed it up under the top tube along with the hydraulic brake hose and the shifter cable, and it comes out here. And I don't think it looks too bad. Some of the bikes I see have just got wires wrapped around the frames and stuff. I just wanted to do a nicer job than that. This is, by the way, this is 10 gauge silicone coated wire. Really soft and pliable. Okay, then back here we've got... let's see, can we shoot down through here? This is the speed sensor. And there's a magnet. Let me see, maybe I can go over on this side and get a better shot. Can you see down through there? Right over there. All right, so when the magnet goes by the sensor, watch the LED light up. See the red LED that goes off? So that's your, that tells the system how fast you're going. And I routed that wire down under the chainstay real nice, and it comes up into the wiring harness under the motor here, which I've bundled up real nicely. Nothing really too much hanging down. It's not hanging down lower than the motor, and this is not an off-road bike going over stumps and rocks and stuff, so this will be fine. Let's see here. Let's go around to this side. And the other sensor that comes up here is the shift sensor. And it comes up around here, and you slide your shift cable through the middle of it. And when the shift cable moves, the sensor can tell the motor to shut off. So you're not shifting gears and the motor is slamming the drivetrain real hard. So when you shift, there's a momentary pause in the motor until you get to your gear, and then the motor comes back on. Alright, so that's all the sensors. Let me show you a little bit about what I did to the drivetrain here. Normally, they give you a great big 40, I think I got a 46 chain ring, but I opted for this smaller 30 Luna chainring. It's got the wide narrow teeth for one. The stock one's a big steel one without that. And this bike is 50 some pounds, and I'm not trying to set land speed records. I need gear down for big hills. So this 30, I think, is going to work out right. I went up some monster hills in the neighborhood last night on speed assist 2 effortlessly with this big old beast. And I added some shelter clear chainstay protectant, because last night I went off-road a little bit and the chain was slapping on here and it already took some paint chips out. So that'll take care of that. Let me show you what I had to do. Oh, by the way, these pedals are just on for the test. I'm going to put my clipless on and go out for a ride later today. I've got to fix the sound on my video camera, and I should be able to get some video footage of this thing. Now, the chain line sometimes is an issue with these big, fat bikes. And let's see if we can look back down through there. And what I did was I saw this tip on one of the e-bike forums. Let's go back here and look. It's a freewheel, it's not a cassette. So if you've got the tool to take a freewheel apart, let me look, shoot down here at this one. See, this outer ring has to come off. And I made a tool out of aluminum to do that. I was lucky that the aluminum it bent a little bit while I was doing it, because these are on really tight. And then once you do that, all these gears come off. But there's two steps. The four lower gears here are all on one tier, and then the three upper gears are on a larger diameter tier. So, whoops, coming apart on me. So what I've done on the bike is move the biggest gear to position 5 and set the stop screw on the derailleur to stop on this. These two that were 5 and 6 previously are just there for spacers. So I have a 5-speed now. It was a 7. And if you look here, you can see this one has a 34. So I've got a 30, 34 for my lowest gear. And then the 5th and 6th gear are behind it, just like on the freewheel I just showed you. So this is for some of the really, really steep stuff we have around here. And you can't move any of the other bigger ones. I would have liked to have 5th and 6th maybe thrown one more lower gear right here. But like I said, this freewheel body is a certain size up to here. And then the diameter increases for these last three gears. So these last three gears do not fit on this lower diameter down here. So, but anyways, this improved the chain line. It's not too bad. I didn't come off last night on my test ride. We'll find out today when I do a little bit more of serious riding here. So, anyways, like I mentioned before, since this is 5th gear now, this is a 7-speed freewheel, I had to set the stop screw for this position. And they were really wimpy little screws that the screwdriver heads just stripped on. So I tapped it out for 8/32 threads for these two. I've got a stainless screw in this one, which I had on hand, but I'm going to get a stainless screw to replace this one here. So it was real easy to tap this out. It's just cheap metal, this derailleur. We'll have to see if that derailleur actually stays in the long run here. It's pretty flimsy. That's the stock derailleur. But anyways, that's the Luna kit. You hold the power button down for a few seconds and it comes on. And I'll have more after the ride report today.